Dear learners, best greetings of the time to all of you. It gives me immense pleasure to present before you the online educational resource on surveying and analysis techniques in urban design. I am Mr. Shashikant Gosavi, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology at Solapur. To begin with, let us see the learning outcomes of this online educational resource. At the end of this session, the learners will be able to carry out different surveys for urban design. The other learning outcome is, at the end of this session, the learners will be able to carry out analysis for urban design of a town. All of us are familiar with the town. The town basically consists of these six elements. The physical elements comprise of the actual topography of the land, the water bodies, the built environment. The social element consists of the neighborhood, the status of the people living there. It may be the educational background or status of the people which are forming the society there. It may be the population and so many other factors. The cultural element consists of the religion, caste, the various types of festivals and the programs which are celebrated by the society. The economic elements consists of the commercial establishment, banks, financial offices, the markets, the earning abilities of the people, and so on and so forth. The ecological element primarily consists of the components relevant to the nature. So, whatever is the pollution level in the air, or whatever is the greenery available into the neighborhood, all these factors do contribute to the ecology of a particular town. Of course, without political will, many things are not possible, and therefore one cannot ignore the importance of political element in the development of any town. The various urban planning techniques are there. How we design our cities influence how people live in them. There are several factors. The predicting population growth is at most important in this particular enterprise. Zoning, primarily dealing with the land use and land cover, is also an important component in designing the urban planning. The geographic mapping and analysis is also important, because many of the developing factors relevant to the town have strong influence of geographic factors. It may be the locational influence, it may be the area, it may be the volume, and so on and so forth. Analyzing the park space is, of course, one of the important elements in urban planning. Surveying the services such as water supply is at most important to ensure that proper care will be taken for the livelihood in the town. Identifying transportation patterns is at most important, because transportation lines are actually the bloodlines of the life of a town. Recognizing food supply demand is important to ensure that the people in the space will be happy and healthy. Allocating healthcare and social services are important to make sure that the health of the people living into the town will be taken care of. Analyzing the impact of land use is, of course, very, very important, because ultimately that decides the direction in which the growth of the town is going to happen in the near future. We have already seen these elements, and there is a strong connection between the planning techniques and the elements. Without data, the planning is that way haphazard. To make sure that the data will be collected, we need to carry out certain surveys. There are primarily four important types of surveys which are carried out for the urban planning. One is physical survey. The land is surveyed to find out the distances, elevations, the angular positions, contours, topology, even the boundaries, all these things are required to be surveyed. Secondly, we need to survey the built environment, the existing construction, their age, the quality, their beauty, all these things do matter while we survey the buildings into the town. We need to make the survey of the land use. This is very, very important. Whether the land is agricultural, whether the land is industrial, whether the land is under some water body, all these factors are utmost important to make sure that the survey will be truly contributing to the planning. One very, very important thing nowadays is important in metros in particular is density. So density of the population, density of the greenery, forest, all these things are important to be surveyed to ensure that the growth of the town will be properly planned. When we carry out the surveys, there are following types of surveying modes. Four main ways are there. One is through in-person interview. When we go to the person and give him a series of questions and get a feedback on that and record it, there are very good chances that response will be there. Secondly, these people remain in our close contact. However, this is practically costly approach. The second possibility is instead of mobilizing ourselves everywhere in the town, one can go for telephonic conversation to collect the response of the people. Of course, the people are not interested to spare their time depending upon their availability and the position, and therefore, relatively, it gets low response. There are some personal contacts in this particular case which can be capitalized. Through the mail is the most popular one in today's context. The mode is that way less costly. It has lower response rate, however. Over the internet, there are several tools through which we can really collect the survey. There are many of the surveying questionnaires which we can construct, such as through the Google Drives, we can get the feedback of the people. There are four surveying techniques. Self-survey means the people on their own will register their opinions about the factors which we are surveying. The officers of the town planning may go to the site and inspect it. That is the second type, which is called as a direct inspection. Here, pinpointed idea must be there for which the information is to be collected. There are personal interviews through which also the surveys can be conducted and the data can be generated. There is, of course, the observer's participation itself, who can record based on certain physical aspects by experiencing himself the various possible convenience factors of the people who were supposed to respond to the survey. The questionnaire is the key to derive proper response from the people. One is the nominal questionnaire. In the nominal questionnaire, we will have a specific type of the questions which are common to all the people irrespective of caste, creed, age, and gender, etc. The ordinal is, however, having a specific order. There is a hierarchy in which the questions will be answered by the respondent. The third one is the interval based. That means there is a specific time interval during which the data will be collected. So based on these three prime varieties of the questionnaire, one can decide which is most suited for a specific purpose of town planning. The analysis of the town planning data is utmost important. After carrying out the survey, there are various themes for which this particular data will be used. And therefore, the thematic analysis is key to the success of planning. I have presented a case of the Seoul town, which is having a specific theme of walkability of the specific region from the residents of Seoul. Here you can easily see the green colored region, which is going to give you the exact idea about which particular region is a paradise for walking. Normally up to around maybe 1.5 kilometer, you can assume that the people can comfortably walk. There are several factors associated with that. The walkability is normally counted in terms of a walk score. So in the green zone, the walk score is expected to be high. Normally, this is within a region of around half kilometer of a particular facility for which the walk score is being calculated. There is a paid shared analysis, pedestrian shared analysis, people find it convenient to move. And there is movability index, which measures the physical ability of the people to be active in that region. Please pause the video for a while and answer the following question. The red part is answering regarding the techniques, and the green part is answer for the modes. I have referred this particular references. Thank you very much.